His leg, he's fighting more fatigue than you are right now.
No saving me! I'm trying to eat!
Your cake doesn't stay long enough anyway. You just put it right in your mouth. You don't even need a plate.
Oh, Dan.
Where's her cake? Is it under the car?
Yeah.
Do you dare?
Danielle's gaining weight.
Who are you?
That wasn't positive, Grandma.
I'm not as big as you yet.
Well, you're only in third grade.
Yeah, and you're 57.
You got 50 years to go, girl. What are you going to lay on 5 pounds each year? That's 250 pounds.
No. You weigh 250?
Well, that's right. You're not supposed to use your brain during the summer. Right?
Just 200.
Just think, 5 pounds a year for 50 years.
Don't!
I would grandma get the dog on tape, too.
How come that dog doesn't eat my Jell-O?
Wants to stay healthy.
You had to wonder about that?
Getting ready to make hay. June 12th.
How many loads of hay start now?
Never had a bale made yet. But a late, late year. Last year we were done at this time with 150 acres. This year the hay's really bad. Hardly there. What'd you say, Tom? What'd you say?
Foxy put a cat in the back of the rock.
What have you got Grandpa doing?
Fixing it, Mike.
What's wrong with it?
Changed him off at this point, too.
Do you have to pay him to fix it?
And it be my checkbook. You didn't bring
your checkbook?
I put it in my piggy bank.
What?
My piggy bank. Because mine is that one with the mailman's cake cut up. That's my piggy bank. So my mom has a special key to open it.
You don't let her have money out of it, do you?
No.
What do you buy?
Batman. Do I just know what their names are?
No.
One's called one. My and two generations. One's called Man Bat. And one's called Skydive.
Well, how did it happen?
You mean that red one?
Yeah, how did that chain come off?
I don't know.
You think them other kids are kind of rough on it?
Only Brad drives it.
Why didn't somebody invent it, Tom? Something more wrong with it. Just a chain.
So you didn't bring your checkbook.
Mm-mm.
Your dad's got a lot of money, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Who's got more money, your mom or
but
your
dad? But I didn't spend myself a dollar yet.
Who's got more money, your mom or your dad?
My mom only has $1.
Oh, would you believe that?
And I got $9.
Do you believe your mom only has $1?
Yeah, she does. Oh, and I only got one. She has more dollars because she only brought $4. And she only has $4. I have $1.
How much do you think she makes an hour?
I don't know.
Cool.
We didn't put it there. We put it in that garbage wagon.
Yeah.
Because you have to haul garbage.
Yeah.
When?
When did that? Last week at home.
But what, did you see our swimming pool in there?
Well, it wasn't in there then.
And then what happened last night with the wind?
It blew out. We put it in there last night. Maybe last night it blew out.
And the wind got really bad.
Yeah. And there. We should give Roxy a bone. We should give Roxy a bone. Do you have any bones?
No.
We don't need them. Keith's dog.
Keith's dog. We have.
Then you'll get time to do your job by yourself.
Where?
Brand new. It maneuvers well. Gets around the hills, the ditches. I haven't wrecked it yet. I only got about an hour on it, 2 hours maybe. 30-inch cut. I think it's going to be okay. What's it meant for?
A boomerang.
Where'd you get this idea of a boomerang?
Batman!
You know, Stuart got a real boomerang from Australia from that one guy for a wedding gift. Stuart got a toy. What if he sent it out into the mountains, would it come back? You'd wonder, wouldn't you?
Is that one with a string?
No string.
It's like the one you saw at Nerf One.
Oh. It keeps saying end on here. I think it's the end.
I think it's on.
And then what?
And then we played with Play-Dohs and Dana knocked our swing down.
Where do you think the kids are now?
They're in the hay mow again.
Don't you think that's kind of dangerous to be up there by themselves? They don't know the hay mow very good.
Stacy's, and she keeps keep and turning it.
Who told her to?
I.
How do you know about it? Did you ever lose one?
Yes.
Well,
and
didn't.
I just think about it. And then I told her about it.
How many days are you staying here?
Like a week.
And then what?
Then I get to, stay there for a week.
Go to Aunt Sharon's.
Go to Aunt Sharon's?
Stacy, what are you doing?
I'm trying to bite in.
Or are you making the tooth looser? Huh? Still there?
Mm-hmm.
I should get you an apple and let you just chomp down on it.
How about some good sticky fudge?
Mm-mm.
And then after you're here for a week, then we take you up and sell you somewhere?
No, to dad. She just stays there. I'm trying to get a grape, and she in a grape, in it, put it in her mouth, it's still loose, and then come out.
Dana was trying to loosen her teeth, just so she could be like
she's
her
going like this. I like this.
She wants to get a dollar under her pillow.
Oh, you got my nerve.
I got $4.
You got four teeth left?
$4.
Did the tooth fairy ever come before?
Yeah.
No.
And she got her dollar. And then got all that.
I got all of it.
Then she put a balloon up.
Did you?
In her hair. And she got one of these dress pants.
Who threw this grape up into my hair?
One of these.
Well, I felt something up in my hair. I told Stacy she has to put the tooth under her pillow, and the tooth fairy will come. And what'd you say?
There is no such thing as a tooth fairy.
Who told you that? Some of your older cousins?
No, no one did.
Because she just thinks about it. That's what.
Good thing we got you to confirm it.
She's the echo.
Kill everyone. All right. Echo.
Now, you know what Danielle does? She saved all her teeth in a little box. She never did give any to the tooth fairy. And she's waiting till she gets all her teeth in a box, and then she's going to put them under her pillow, and she expects to get a lot of money. She never did. Get your tongue out of there. Twist it around. Okay, you can see it hanging down now. Okay, we can see it.
Like a twist it, I guess.
Snake tongue going in and out. And I'd say by tomorrow we'll have that sucker out. Look like a monkey.
My turn!
Bend his finger back. Ruin him. I don't care. Ruin him.
Ow.
What?
My turn.
Don't let him do it.
My turn.
Oh, there's more leaves.
Okay, you that. I'm full leaves up now.
My turn, Steve. My turn.
No. Here, you found the leaves. Hey, good. I did. This is the wrong leader.
Dana, up in a tree.
Dana, wee. Dana, up in a tree. Dana, wee.
Why me, Grandpa?
Wait for Grandpa to come.
I think we need your ladder. Grandpa, come up here. They don't want you up there. Then we all crash.
Well, we can anyway if I do.
Don't you have something that won't make any marks? Oh, you could swing from him then?
Yeah. You could swing on him. Well, on this tree up there.
How about the small knives?
I didn't understand that.
If she bumps in the tree, she'll be hurt in the back. If she bumps into me, look what happens. See?
What?
It hurts my leg. It hurts my leg. So
well,
move it, Gramps.
We got a problem, don't we?
So, take it off of it.
No.
Grandpa, come on, move it.
Move it where?
Move it to over there.
Where?
Right over there, Grandpa. I'm going to have on it.
Well, just a minute.
No! Now it's swinging on it. Dana.
It's pouring down rain.
Watch out, Dana. I'm going to hit you.
I got it.
too much on it.
I just gotta start like this.
It's going good.
Go this way.
I can't
this way.
Let's try a shorter one.
I can jump in.
I think so.
Hey, Charlie.
You all right, Tom?
Here.
Hi.
Run out, Tom. Hi.
How many did we get that time?
Two.
Okay.
One. I know, I got up on three high again. I didn't think it was
easy. This is not easy, guys.
How many did you roll the harder for the
dog? A
kid. I don't know where her bottom is.
You may care to join us in the television room.
And do your show.
Yeah.
Let's see it really close.
It's gone. I'm gonna get money by the kind. Yeah, but I'm gonna show my mom first. Daniel has this big jar of teeth, and she's gonna wait until she loses all her teeth, and then make. I know. I am.
What?
I'm. Yeah. The United States. What do you mean? Yeah.
Jump.
Joseph Frederick. Very nice.
That's a zooming in and zooming out.
I know.
Joseph.
I know. How do you do?
Frederick. $30.
Keep going. Makes a healthy body, doesn't it?
I didn't do anything yet. Okay, please.
Hi, my name is Maggie, and we're here to pronounce the game Racco. It's very interesting, very good for in the car, and it's very good for the country sideway in the letter J.
It is on, Grandma.
Racco. The best game.
See, I just let it take.
And it's a great game to play in the car for a ride.
And there's Dina.
And
get out of my
all
way.
The venting. This is belong to the car. We play it in the
and
house somewhere.
Dinner.
And then we just had the program made by Joseph J. Frederick, 3927 Country Highway, A. Lester, WL 53813. And then,
goodbye.
This
what
no, I'm telling you what this game.
What is it?
This big game. She got a G, and it's coloring like that, and it has a big
Dana, hole. Look at the camera.
And then I fashioned the flip. And there's not the thing on there. So this is the magic trick. See? Nothing in there. Huh? You think? It's not in there. So abracadabra. Here comes out. There's part of it. So I did the magic trick and put in all my and then you get the back in there.
You can see.
Then you blow it around. And then look at. See? It flaps out and it goes on my fingers. It adds, I don't want that on my fingers. Watch.
Wait, I'm not done.
See? Not on my fingers. Little tiny bunny stick. That was not it. Story is that's the like Beauty and the Beast. You have to reach you way on up there. Then you crack it and peace.
And then on the tips.
And then all of a sudden the flow comes to all the way to our house. And it knocks on our door and no one's there. The wind just blow it. They picked one of these up. See? There's nothing there. You always have to check on her. She's beautiful. And you take one of these seeds and put it down her shirt. And then you wrap it open. And she just try to crack it open. Remember to crack it open. And then you get an egg, crack it open. See, this get an egg and crack it open. That's
go
the
get
most
an egg.
Important part. Give me egg. Should I really? Can I? Thanks. Oh. A one, a two, and this, an egg, the ball.
And then you gotta crack it all the way.
No.
You gotta smash it.
Save a dish to save it. Get a dish to save it.
Drip on the dish.
Now crack.
I didn't know we could do stuff like that. And then you take this out and mix it with your hands.
What are you doing?
We're trying to make sausage.
Well, who wants to use that egg now? You got your
hand.
Okay, now put the sunflower seeds in. Say.
What are you making?
I'm making chocolate cake.
No, she's making. She's making salted. Salted. Sunflower seeds.
Me too.
What?
You guys eating these?
This. No, put it in here.
No. Grandma.
That was going to be for a treat.
Ooh. Sorry, Drams.
Drams? Well, who's going to eat that?
Put the shell in there.
Who's going to eat it now?
Sissy knows Dana, you have to eat it. Dram.
No, I'm making it for the kittens. The baby kittens.
And here's your cat.
Will they like this, Grandma?
It's cellophane cat food.
What's my name?
Grandma.
Okay, what'd you call me just before?
Grandma.
No, Drama.
Grandma.
Here's our famous cat food.
And then you mix it up.
I think you're done mixing it.
Nope. Mix this up.
What'd you just put in there?
Can we make that commercial?
He'll like it.
I didn't know we could do stuff.
Who'll like it?
Kittens. Tastes much better. It tastes good. Kittens. Want it, Graham.
Yeah.
Grandma will like this.
I'm not eating it.
Yes, you are. I make it for you.
What else do you need in there?
All this stuff in there.
Put a little bit on your face and then wait for it to get dry and then it'll get real. It'll really dry hard on your face. It might be like a mud pack. Put some on your face like this. Yeah.
No.
No, that's what people do when they go to the beauty shop. They get some egg pack.
They do.
They really do. And then when it dries, you can hardly smile. It'll just crack your face. You see, you can't even crack a smile. Oh, brother.
Cat food, I guess.
Maybe you could sell this idea to General Mills.
You're kidding.
That's a cereal company.
Will they eat this?
It's a cereal company that Stewie
works
for.
No, they won't eat it, Tina. They'll throw it in the garbage.
You can be an inventor.
So
a new recipe.
A new recipe.
Okay, now taste it.
Doesn't even know.
No. We gotta have tasters.
Dana, a taster.
Nope.
No, the kitten have tasters.
If your gown was any lower, what would happen? Your dress in front, if that was any lower, what would happen?
The boobies would show. It just takes a long time.
Now you're choking her. I think you've mixed it enough.
No, I have to mix this up. Yeah.
I didn't know you liked to mix like that.
Really? Really?
Put some on your face. I dare you.
No.
Should I do it?
Yeah. You do it. Graham, you do it.
I will. Dana, do you want to try it?
No.
Starting to get hard already. Do it. It's fun.
No.
My face is starting to get hard already.
Did I do it, Danny?
Well, lean over the table. Put it where you have wrinkles.
I don't have any wrinkles.
Put it where you would smile. Now get some more out of the dish.
No.
You don't wipe it on my table. Dana, try it on your face.
Well, if I mix this up.
Hurry up, I'm running out of tape. Can you feel it getting hard already, Stace?
And you have to have enough for us, too.
Don't smile until it gets hard, and then you can smile. Ready, Dana? Put some on your face. Right in the where you would smile. Just put all over your cheeks on both sides. Now go back in and get some more. This is the beauty shop here. Stace, you feel yours getting hard?
It didn't go crack because I didn't put enough. You smile, Grandma.
Hmm?
You
smile.
Grandma never smiles.
I'm not like you.
Ew.
I just make you smile.
I can taste it.
Now, look this way, Dana.
It tastes thick. It's great to use on your face. Change the subject. It's great to use on your face.
Yeah,
it's going to be harder.
Is it starting to get hard?
Yeah.
Somebody blow on it and get it hard faster.
Mine's starting to get hard.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
What does it feel like?
Cool, but I mean...
Black newsprint all over.
Yes, you do.
It stuck to the eggs. It did.
Yes, it did.
Well, take your hands down and we'll look.
No.
So
she goes in
the bathroom
in the
month. I put no
water
so I can feel it
easier. If you
that's
went out,
what I made it for.
Yeah, that's what you made it for. If you go out in the sun, it'll dry it. Don't rub it off. Don't go out in the sun, let the sun shine up for just a minute. Count to 20 and then you'll feel it get hard. I don't even want you touching any doorknobs on the way out.
I washed my hands though.
Face pack.
Egg.
Face
pack. With nuts and
rings. Here's the smile.
It's cracking.
Is it hard?
Yeah.
Can you crack a smile?
Get your glove on here.
No.
It's hard
in your face.
Wait, I'll leave this one. Uncle Jim. Picks this up.
Uncle Jim?
And he's Uncle Jim.
That's not Jim.
Bring his peeking doll on the way down.
What's his what?
Then he flipped the sled and showed the book.
Dana, what was that? What were you hitting on him?
His butt.
What'd you call it in Greek?
PC
no. PC no?
Okay, she's staying there for...
Then...
Your way. You don't mind that we're a stick of pins in your ceiling, do you?
It won't really show.
Scoot your hand back.
If you put straight in, straight up, I mean?
Yeah.
What is this, a curtain hanging?
Don't put your hand there, Stace. Put it the other one there.
Can't let Tom see that, Grammy. You're just wasting it.
Behind the curtain?
Just turn it off.
Don't move your perch.
What is this for?
It's the curtain.
For what?
For a commercial. No, you can't see in here.
So you can't see your kitchen.
Faces and hair cells.
Wait. Go over there. I'm going to tape you. Got to say, oh. Wait. Before you start, I'm going to go over there and say, this is Stacy practicing for Crayola Fashion Designer Kit. Dana, you can't be over there.
You can't see me.
Yeah, we can, because we're going to be over there. So you can't be there.
Really?
No, you can't. Now get out of the way. Dana, get out of the way. Back there. You're going to do that.
First, I'm going to do my show.
We'll tape you after a while.
But I'm going to do my full show.
Yep, it is right now. I'm taping it, everything right now. Crayola Fashion Designer Kit. This is Stacy Frederick. Take one for commercial Crayola Fashion Designer Kit.
After you get dressed for town,
why do I have to put... I have to go to town. Oh, tell me. Yeah. Hi, I'm Stacy Frederick, and I would like to do a commercial for you about Crayola Fashion Designer Kit. Mix, match, and combine 36 fashion designers, faces, and hairstyles. Includes over 60 accessory stickers. Choose from over 50 accessories on the accessory. Stencil. Choose from six different backgrounds, 9 different fabric patterns to choose from. Thank you.
This is take one of Stacy Frederick for the commercial Crayola Fashion Designer Kit. Crayola Fashion Designer Kit. Let's hand it over to Stacy.
Designer kit. Mix, match, and combine
36 fashion designers. Faces and hairstyles includes over 60 accessory stickers. Choose from over 50 accessories on the accessory stencil. Choose from 6 different backgrounds, 9 different fabric patterns to choose from.
I gotta stop now.
That's gonna be repeated on there then.
That's fine. Doesn't matter.
We gotta get you into the...
Yeah, I will do it 1 second, Grandma.
I have a cone.
Okay, get over there, Stace. Hurry up.
Do you like that job?
Mm-hmm. Wait. Grandma can't eat this yet.
How'd you learn how to do that?
Oh, with if I was 3, I used a little knife and so little, and then that's how I learned how to cut. And if you, here, I'll show you something. This. See, cut it like, all the way like, through this. And, see, now I'll show you. See, big piece, big piece. You have to turn it around so you can cut it more. Right corner. And most on the side. See? If you get this, I'll show you. See? And you cut this part. See how you do it? Put it a little around the bird.
Why? Why?
Because they were following us, and
Oh, they were nosy.
Yes. I hit them right here. We were just throwing rocks at them, and I hit one of the cows right here.
Maybe you gave it a headache, or maybe it's going to be sick. Tell me, why did you walk home, you two?
Because I thought,
What?
Grandpa. I thought Grandpa told us. I thought Grandpa said yes. So I told Stacy, but I didn't know what he said. That's why.
And then?
She got in trouble.
Did Grandpa get mad?
Yes.
Did he say you shouldn't walk so far?
No.
Did he pick you up?
Yes. We walked most. We should have been there by now.
So you walked from the other place? Stacy, was it where they have a house on it, where people live, or is it the place with no house?
It's the place with a house.
With the house?
Scott's house.
You didn't walk that road.
Yes.
Did you walk past the rock quarry?
What? What do you mean?
That place where you play with rocks. Did you walk past that?
Yes.
That's about a mile long.
We were like on the boat.
You should never walk home when Grandpa took you somewhere. You should always wait for him. What was he doing?
I don't know. Working on the tractor.
So why didn't you stick around and wait with him?
Because he was taking so long.
And then you should toot the horn and ask him, when are you coming, or something like that.
She did.
Oh. So you hit the cow with a rock.
Yes.
Maybe it's going to die.
I don't care. I hate those cows.
How do you think we make a living?
Oh, maybe not. Maybe.
How do you think we make money? We have to have those cows to milk them. You don't want
to have another cows.
Yeah,
we have. Your area, you don't want to go everyone's houses to feed cows. They can do it. The dad, the brother, or the sister, too.
No, those are our cows. We have to take care of them.
Yeah, maybe they can do them for us.
Nobody wants to do our job. Everybody else has a job in town. It's easier than taking care of cows. Don't you think it's easier? They get a check when they go to work. They like what they're doing, and we're supposed to like what we're doing.
They're supposed to.
Yeah.
And Grandpa, Grandma, look at this beautiful rock.
Did you think that Grandpa likes what he's doing?
Yeah.
You think he likes his job?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you think Keith likes his job?
Yeah.
Do you think Bruce likes his job?
Yeah.
Ask him sometime.
If he didn't, then why would they be doing it?
Right. And did you know the hired man got all his beard taken off?
Yeah.
What does he look like now?
What's a mustache?
That's gone too.
Like this.
But what does he look like?
He looks like Uncle Jim.
He never did have a beard.
Yes, he did. He did. It probably got hot.
Oh, maybe it didn't get hot. Grandma, how can
I'm still that Grandma.
Be hot?
Well, hair on your face is hot. Don't you think?
In Iowa, 1 mile.
I believe it.
What more do you got?
Make a pizza, make a pizza.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Tell me what you're doing.
Oh. On the toaster. On the toaster. On the toaster. On the toaster. On the toaster.
Yummy.
1, 2, 3, buck more.
We're making a pizza.
One toaster. One. Oh, where's my pan? Oh, where is my pan?
Stacy, you're getting them very neat.
I am too, Grandma.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
I mean, licking it. Ooh, you're not supposed to lick.
I'm licking out of my fingers.
Oh, I think you were licking the bread dough. Weren't you? Isn't this like playing with Play-Doh?
No.
It's yeah, not?
It feels like it's sticking to my fingers.
Are you just about finished?
I am done.
How much? Help Dana with her pan then.
No.
Looks like she's got a little bit more room left in hers.
How come the whole thing? Wait till I'm done with this.
Why is Dana doing that, Mom? Sloppy, not in
because water. When you were her age, yours weren't perfect either.
Here, give me some. Bring our little neck pull.
I don't think you're supposed to pull bread dough. Look how she can roll them so good now.
They're a little too small.
Yeah, they're going to be for little kids, I guess.
The bread is all done.
Who helped make it? What?
What, Grandma? What did Grandma say?
She's coming upstairs to see what I look like with the camera on.
Why?
Lock the door.
Hurry up, get in here.
Come, welcome to our home. This is our porch.
Get in there.
Welcome to our porch.
And I'll welcome you.
Come, welcome to our house. Excuse us, but it's kind of a mess.
Excuse you, you haven't made your bed. You didn't make your bed from this morning.
It's still nighttime.
I know. Nighttime.
Legs. Close.
This is Dana's pile. Well, this is the junk pile. And move the camera. This is our fan. This is a dress. This is our bench dress.
That's my coat laying on the floor.
And this is our
raining in the window.
Okay, now get out.
The bloom. Please. Iris.
Find it.
Recording and I kept walking off right over the edge of the wall. Would that be funny?
Yeah. Camera hides. How about you get down so you can see me go up? Get back where you were.
No, I don't think that. Now you quit the same as everybody else did.
One.
You didn't throw.
Just take three steps. Two, three.
Take your punishment. You get to throw it, Tom.
Dana wins.
Oh, keep going.
No.
No, Dad. Give the wristbands to him. Everybody gets the wristband back.
Who's purple?
Purple.
Daddy, are you purple?
Give all mine back.
Mine.
Okay, Tom starts.
You're a good throw.
Throw it, Tom.
You're a good one.
No, you throw it up in the air and see which color it is.
Throw it up in the air. Throw high.
Line.
Tom, do
line.
It again.
Line.
Was it?
Okay.
I have to do it again.
Okay, don't anybody hit it.
Oh, good one.
Straight up, Tom.
No.
Take three steps.
She caught it.
I'm going to get
not recording.
Here. She's got it. I'll be sure you get down there, and then Grandma will have to pick you up. At what time?
Don't, Dana.
3 o'clock.
Where you? Dana, quit it.
And we're going to be playing.
What else do you do?
I'm
sitting here, Dana.
You need a hammer?
Yeah.
How'd you do it?
Turning off with that sticky.
I never can do that.
Do that.
That has some good Frederick noses to do that.
I can't get
it either.
She's got it.
You can't laugh when you do it.
That's for sure.
Right about this time of year.
No, Rock Time. I want my spot. I want to take your stuff over there, Tom. Take your stuff over there.
Why are you kids on the porch?
Because it's raining!
Oh, you don't have to holler it.
Dad, this was out in the rain.
The dog? On my tablecloth.
Grandma? I do want to get this one. Grandma, is Danielle there tonight? Who's going to miss her all day?
Miss who?
Danielle.
You've been with her for about 7 days?
No.
Sounds like a good idea.
I'm going to get some more rain in my cup.
Here's this one. I want to get some candy.
Yeah.
Hey,
I'm raining.
You drink water that comes off a dirty roof?
No, this is the water that comes off here.
Yeah, it's off the dirty roof.
What? Grandma, you think it's
safe? It's dirty. Believe me, it's dirty. If you go out and catch it out of the sky, it's clean, but not off the dirty roof.
It's too wet.
Ew! You should drink.
I think the pigs will get wet.
That doesn't hurt them.
Tom, they're always wet.
Pigs can use a bath.
Mommy, no, I showered.
Oh, yeah.
Tommy, you can't take all of that water, all of that 7-Up, only a glass, half a glass full.
It is going to stop. Never going to have a rainbow.
And then it's going to be a sunny day.
Your kids can run out barefoot better than having shoes get wet. Now we really got rainwater coming.
Okay.
You don't want to drink that, do you?
I have little raindrops.
That's good for you. Put your tongue up in the sky. There we go. It's good for you.
No, it's not.
You're going to get rain
I
on you.
I'm going to put it up in the sky.
Wait. How about this, Grandma?
I am.
Go ahead. You know what Dana used to do last year? Stick her whole head in there and come back up. Stacy.
I'll do that again.
What?
Stacy.
See? I did it.
Remember last year Dana used to put her head in there? We got a picture of it.
Grandma, I hope she stuck her whole head in the bucket.
She did. Last year.
Her whole head, though, she used to do. Do that again, Dana.
No.
Yeah.
Move it, Poopy. Move it.
There ya. Yeah.
Not good. Tom do it. And I'll do it.
Double dare you,
Dana.
Two, three.
Dunk your head anymore?
Nope.
Why?
Huh.
Stacy, you do it, then I swear I will do it.
No, I'm not gonna do it. Dad, then I'll do it first. And then
yeah.
There's Roxy. Let me do it, Roxy.
Roxy's chicken.
That's why she
wants it.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, Batman lady. What? Drop me. Jingle bells, Batman bells, Robin lady. Batmobile,
and Joker
got away.
And Joker took ballet. Tom, why are you making fun of Batman when you like him?
Is there something wrong with my taste when Joker sings it?
How do you know?
Can you hear him coming?
Yeah.
It's Rick. It's Rick, because Rick does it. He has a rough on.
Call the cab.
And it's raining hard again.
Roxy! Roxy! Come on, Daniel!
Hey,
Stacy! Roxy! Roxy!
I got it. Hey, sounds like Indians.
Look at me, Grandma.
Get my water from there.
I got out of, I got given to me an auction.
Take one of
wait for a rainy day.
Are there umbrellas in the car, Stacy?
What? You think the storm is over? A lot of noise. Sun's out. We got to wait for a rainbow.
I could be the penguin.
Is that what's on Batman?
Yes.
How about Mary Poppins?
What?
How about Mary Poppins? Doesn't she have an umbrella?
Okay, the sun strides off the rain. It's bitsy off the spider. Turn off the spout again.
Do it again because I didn't get the first part.
It's
bitsy spider. Turn off the water box.
Out in the rain and watch the fire out. Out in the sun and
the rain.
It's
a bitchy
spider.
Out in
the rain.
Come
again.
Out
in the rain.
Out in the rain.
Out in the rain.
Watch the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain, and the itsy bitsy spider went down the water.
Went up the spout again.
Okay.
And it's snoring. It's old man, it's snoring.
No.
It's raining, it's pouring. The old man is
snoring. Snoring.
It's pouring. I'm to them.
Look at
you. Ooh, it rains.
It's, what's up? It's raining. It's pouring. The old man is snoring.
It's raining, not grandma. It's old man, it's snoring.
Man.
With Danielle.
They have to go get some cows.
Huh?
They had to go get some cows for Grandpa.
What?
You heard me.
No. One more. Please, Grandma. What?
They had to get some cows for Grandpa so he could start milking. Because they wouldn't come in. They were bad. So they have to go get them. Just like kids that don't come in for lunch, you have to go get them. Right?
Okay.
will love you and honor you all the days of my life. I am the young lady who is to work with my husband. I promise to be good to you in good times and in bad. In sickness, for God and the church, may the Lord in his wisdom strengthen your consent. Will you both? God has joined man or woman.
About Andrea and I. And, you know, I never really answered the question. I kind of dodged it. And it wasn't that I didn't have an answer, but I didn't quite know how to express what the answer would be. So here I am a couple years later, Stu, and I say I'm pretty much in the same position. The family that have come. Well, with that, why don't we all raise our glasses, drink a toast to Stuart and Aunt.
On behalf of Andrea and myself, I'd like to thank everyone for coming. As Dean said, the folks in this room tonight have really meant a lot to both of us. We really appreciate your support and love and time that we've shared with every one of you. There are a lot of people here from the local area. We've known Mary and Joel Frederick, Andrea's parents, for a long time and really supported the Frederick family, which I can add at this point is a very strong, loving family. But there are also a lot of other folks who are from out of town, from North Carolina, Tennessee, Milwaukee, Nevada, all over the place. And in fact, as Dean had mentioned, I think the Long Distance Traveler Award goes to Rick Slovic from Australia. How are you, Rick? You know, it just so happens to be Rick's birthday tomorrow, as well as Keith Frederick's. And I think Doug Foddy over here said drinks were on him. But thanks for coming, Rick. Thank you for everyone for coming. I guess I'd like to acknowledge a few people tonight. Two of them, of which are Mary and Joe Frederick, which, again, are Andrea's parents who have really supported Andrea through the years and have actually made the reception happening tonight. So if they could, I'd like them to stand up and have a The other individual has really helped out a lot tonight, and in fact, there's another wedding coming up in September with my mom, Carolyn, who's sitting over here. Mom, could you stand up, please? And as many of you know, and a few of you don't, my father passed away in August, but he was always a favorite of ours and really enjoyed meeting Andrea, and we think of you tonight, Dad. And I would, of course, like to thank Chris Van Hook. And if you don't know her, just call her Hooker. Andrea's best friend and confidant. And we really appreciate your time and the time we've spent with you, and as well as Dean Hammond over here on my right. As Dean mentioned, we've been together for about 5 years. And I think I've learned a lot from Dean. And the times that we've spent together have definitely been quality time, and every time that Andrea and I will get along and we'll talk to Dean, and I see her about a week later. Well, I said to Andrea, I said, well, what time would you like to leave? I said, do you just want to sneak away or, you know, say goodbye? I said, how about 11:30? We got an early morning flight, we got to get the heck out of here. And she said, oh, no. I'm staying till the bitter end. So if you do leave tonight and we're still here,
I can ditto everything that Stuart said. Both our parents have been so much help. Stuart may not know all the details that went into this because he's a man. All of us here can appreciate this, so I want to have a special thanks to my mother who really coordinated a lot of things here. And we, between a lot of priority mails that we did between one another and phone calls, we got a lot done. George just kind of stood by and he told his mother in a phone call, watch me go through all the phases that brides to be do. And he, when I was getting mad at him, he laughed it all off and thought, oh, phase number two, here she goes. And he said, Mom, you know, she's got this thing going. It's like with the women, it's like when they have a baby or something, this special bond and they're all getting along. So Stuart's been laughing all along, up and down, but we did a lot of planning. We had a lot of fun planning this, and special thanks to our parents and everyone else in the wedding party. A lot of you traveled, and we appreciate it a lot. It's very special that you came here. So thank you to everyone else, and we hope you have a great time. We've got the band starting soon, so thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.
Nicole, you look like the school. Grandma. That's Tammy, but...
Watch out, Dana.
You can actually move around this picture and make it look like real.
I'm just getting in the middle and go around.
I'm not touching. I'm not touching.
I'm not.
Make it a complete circle, please.
Monkey in the middle.
Get the little ones in there. Mom, put around here. Okay. We're going to say a very simple one you've all heard before. It's a rocker room prayer. God is great. God is good. We thank you. Scram in the kitchen.
Well, hello. Sorry.
Eat with mine eyes.
I've never been the first in life. What's the rules for
that? Two rolls. Two sandwiches.
Came one off, right?
Coach. I gotta go and get
foggy for an hour. I have to go to our house. Let Harrison take a
minute. They promised to be back by 3, Jan. I didn't get you in the beginning, so I had to come and get you now.
She's got you. She isn't coming.
These two are together, but they're kind of apart right now.
She's supposed to talk.
See, you were late, so.
Yay.
What about the bears?
Down in front.
Where's your brother's at?
Way back.
And I'm sure she's thrilled. So next year, the Fredericks will be hosting us for Christmas.
There are ornaments for Andrew Stewart, but we'll let those until Stewart gets back and they can open that for them.
You know, this is being recorded, and Stewart hasn't written in from 1992 yet.
I already did.
Stewart's done.
Good.
15 minutes ago.
Good. Why? Because otherwise everybody keep asking, Stewart didn't write in here from last year yet.
I did see that.
He had his arms out and his head out, hanging upside down. That's where they rescued him. They took the brick out of his mouth.
Take the brick out.
And they were very ungrateful to the cops that were doing it.
Were they mad?
Yeah. He was belligerent as could be.
What'd the lady send out as Christmas gifts to her friends then?
She took the picture up and that's what she put on her Christmas card.
She said, drop in any time and visit us.
Oh, that was cute.
Why?
That was just a cat.
She a cat.
Anybody get Gak?
Is that Jack Hopper?
What is this? What is that, Dana? Can we get it? Can we get it? Oh, we need Dana.
Oh, what? We don't get it. We'll see Jana.
Mommy!
Is there anyone who has a bad reader? Well,
oh,
Jack and Slater. Wow. Of
course he plays all the time. Wow. Oh, Nellan, that's.
Let's see what that is.
I thought the movie could have been.
We're gonna need scissors.
Oh,
Some scissors in that drawer there, Dave.
I hope it works.
Ellie, we'll have to buy some batteries for it.
Some BQ?
One more.
Andrew, don't tell me you mail that. Bunch of boxes? It's going to be in a box inside of a box.
I didn't buy it.
I don't want to pay a present.
No, I don't want to pay a present. Tom, I got you picking your butt. Tom. I saw it.
Merry Christmas.
I'm trying to get the onion, Nancy.
Oh, I thought she was filming me.
Oh, I'm sure you got it. Where's Patty?
Jamie. It didn't
like
go. Great, I'm on film.
Technology.
I also want to take a picture.
I think it's film record.
13 cows. Hey, in the barn. It's a 13 cow cord. Yeah, we know it's coiled.
Who is?
This friend in bed, Mom. Bed Grandpa.
Daddy.
Oh,
Daddy.
Look at how pretty that is. You get these things.
Don't you?
Mom, mommy.
Is
that cute?
Everybody.
Hey, that's
cute.
No, I don't, Mom.
In the front.
See,
they're entitled
to that.
How
about you? Isn't that what you're waiting for? Yeah.
Here, Nancy.
That is really cute.
Yeah,
but it is. Yeah,
this is
Dana.
I miss everything with the one behind me.
Oh, no.
This would be a fun dress up together.
That's for Uncle Dave.
Got a routine. What is
the exponent.
Well, I remember that.
I'll tell you.
In college?
I don't think it was a center.
It was behind his desk. You know how it slips down behind, you know? Well,
that'd be interesting.
Yes, sure.
She's got cows and horses. That's nice. Thank you. Oh,
yeah. Let's see, Dana. Woo!
Oh, thank you.
It's got horses on it.
Have we been down through it all, Stacy? We haven't got to the bottom. Let's see. Oh, would this be for me? Ooh. No go.
Grandma wanted you to have this in your room, Stacy.
Hey, it's mine.
You put it out on your bookstand so you can read at night.
Who would those be for? They've been you or this is
you. You should be able to get it to Dana.
Keith, you got a lot of good stuff in yours?
Good to me.
You don't have little kids though anymore.
Who's they said you? Or if they got a good
Dana.
Oh,
those
fit
100%.
They each
lost
one,
so
they need a pair.
Oh, socks I've left? Yeah. Whose socks are these? Who left these here in farm?
Channel 47.
Oh, I have
show in the morning.
What number are you?
I like them.
That when did you leave happens,
here? She's everything we've left here is in here too.
GF. Where did you get yours? Underwear.
Well, that's right. You don't wear underwear.
Did you get a roll call ticket?
She didn't on the way home because they left it here.
What it is?
Hope somebody's eye out.
We have pictures of Jana without underwear.
Dad!
Oh,
nice.
Oh, gee, not
we're going.
I remember this, too.
Is this Brandon's son?
Is that what this is?
Oh,
I was just thinking about
the boys are going to this family.
Oh, somebody's tired.
Things I forgot about. Get your glasses.
Tell me your glasses.
All right.
Nancy.
Pick it.
Yeah. Man. Jeez.
Man. They might have come that weekend.
Looks
like someone else
today.
What?
Let me take your
well, that looks crimp and proper.
I like the way you do it.
Looks like you've been at Sears too much, Ellen.
Friday?
Don't ruin my pose.
I'm late. Excuse me, the red is on. This is REC right in here.
Okay.
Thank
you. Do this one.
Okay, Ellen and Tommy and Trudell going to take care of this.
Okay, your mom wants it down there. Tommy got a hat. You know what?
Thanks, Keith.
For me?
Hey.
Ellen, you got another tooth. Oh, let me see.
Put it on.
For what?
I'll help you.
Yeah.
Ellen. Yeah. Hang on to me.
Ellen.
Oh, Ellen. Should we play Barbies when I come over?
Mm-hmm.
Ellen, this one, where is
yours
too?
This is
Todd. Wow.
Where are yours two?
That's big. Ellen,
Stacy, test
that deli right there.
Is Grandpa's old hat?
Is it close?
I don't know.
I know. I've never been to that place.
Mom, come here.
Look at
close your eyes.
Christine Kenosha. So it's either right on the Wisconsin border or
Attic.
Oh. I want to hear it too. It's good though.
Take it easy at the best
question. Tom, turn around.
Nice.
Well,
then
you
gotta
get
well
by March.
Tommy, you put this on your bike.
It makes a whistling sound.
We'll know
when
you're
coming.
You get it done already, Shane?
Huh? Yeah, they only wanted that one.
You mean they never took another one? What's the matter with them? Can't they make up their mind? I thought they already took one.
It's 5 o'clock.
They just... And who made... Who skinned it?
Huh?
Who skinned it?
My Uncle Jack. He had a butt infection in it.
Okay. See, get Lenny to turn. Lenny, I got the side of your face. There.
Hello.
Gotcha.
Lean right back, here. Mom.
Good.
Right back.
You got a telephone on your
leg. That's a bad spot. That's my gym. That's a bad spot.
So this afternoon I got you sleeping on the couch.
Did you?
Really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, and Dave.
Does that look good?
Well, you look better than the last time I saw you.
Sleeping on the couch. What's better looking?
Oh, you're going to step on us. Okay.
Dino.
Great.
Yeah,
they told me
when
to turn them off.
Oh.
Down the dinosaur, cha-cha-cha. They can really be rough, cha-cha-cha. Just shake your tail and hoist your sail. We're off to dinosaur, cha-cha-cha. Round and around and up and down. Round and around and up and down. Round and around and up and down. We're doing dinosaur, cha-cha-cha. Down and dinosaur, cha-cha-cha. They can really be rough, cha-cha-cha. Just shake your tail and hoist your sail. We're off to dinosaur, cha-cha-cha. Round and around and in and
you got bow.
You need a couple props for the next one.
Very good.
Zip up, Andrew.
Maybe we could have the second show our way for the completion of the
third. Are you going to sing your song?
Oh my. You've been waiting.
You made it
now.
I've never heard that
before. You know? What'd you say? Okay. Black Man's Playboy.
Come on!
The lights are out. We can see ya.
Dana, that's fine.
Must be an animal. Come on.
Come on, Dana.
Come on, Dana.
Dana, we can't see. It's covering up everything.
Little elf, as you work upon yourself, working hard to make the toys. All for little girls and boys. Gasping, little elf, as you work upon yourself.
Good.
Well, that was short. All right.
Is there a costume change?
Is there anything?
Hey!
Very good.
That means he went down.
He got all the dragon on driveway.
How did that? Dana, how did the thing go down the drain?
Well,
she
not the
she wants you to show.
Okay.
Hey. Oh.
That third time she just stayed there. You wouldn't have nowhere else to fall.
What does that look like?
In her own row.
She was a regular
bed.
Yeah, she
was 4 bedrooms.
I think I've only been up there.
Or the basement. Get the hair out of the way. I want to get this big bubble.
Actually, over to the house.
Don't touch it!
A couple
times. Can it come down and look at my hand?
spank it.
Spank the butt right now.
Ellen, yours is getting really good.
I'll break the butt now.
It's not so sticky anymore, is it?
I'm breaking the butt now.
Keep turning it over.
Yeah. Now you.
Ellen, you gotta keep turning yours over. Boy, yours is getting good.
Whose?
Ellen's.
Mine?
Yours was good.
It's already good?
Yeah, yours is already good. Hers, remember we were worried about hers being sticky? Now it's just perfect.
Let's do silly things.
So you can roll it into a snake.
When I and a smile, and it wrecked the nose. Okay, let's roll it up in a snake. First, we get a pretty little song. And then we made a snake, and then we just roll the snake up into a little ball.
Tom had his kindergarten clothes on, and now we put an apron on him.
And then we throw the snake down, and and then you hold it up and see what
looks works. Like a chicken hanging down. Quack! Quack, quack, quack!
My eyes move.
Yeah. Beautiful? How much you come out in the kitchen and play with Play-Doh?
I'm done.
You're done? What do you need? Ellen, what do you need? A hat?
Yeah.
What do you call her?
Hershey. Say Hershey. You let her down, please? She wants to walk. What if she wants to walk? Look at it. It's a boy.
It's as big as you are.
Look at it.
It's a boy?
Yeah,
down
the bottom, it doesn't have any tips. I don't want him down.
This is where he
pees.
It's a
rapey.
You
want to
lay him?
Not here. No, here. Only leave him up here. Not here. Now, let him down.
Hi, Hershey.
I'll
go this way. Maybe you
want
to go this way.
Yeah, well, she walks.
She walks.
Where is she? I
have
two.
She walks.
I have two.
Or he. It's a he.
She. Some of them are she. I'm going to go and walk and see
her. She calls her she, and you call her Hershey.
Come on, let's see a tape. I'm going to watch TV. I want to hold up. Here. I want to hold this up.
Let her hold him.
Aww.
It's a big, fat
dog.
No. He doesn't go in my living room.
Hershey.
I see.
No, they don't have
tits. It's a boy.
Tom, lay them down. Hi, Hershey. Hi, Shu. He can go wherever he wants.
Yeah.
He just looked me. This sushi just looked me. Hi. Look at me. Hi. This one kissed me in the nose. Look at this stuff.
Look at that tail moving.
Me.
For sure, he likes kids.
What? He likes